Did you know one of the best ways to stop paddle drips is to change the way you paddle? Let me show you what I've learned this week on Kayak Hacks.
Welcome back! If you're new to the channel, we cover kayak modifications, spin, and fly fishing. So poke that subscribe button so you don't miss anything.
I transitioned to kayaks from canoes, and one of the things I had to learn when I got in a kayak was how to paddle. So I talked to some experts, I looked at some videos, I looked around the internet, and the bottom line is that there are two ways you can paddle. You can do a high stroke or a low stroke. Now obviously, when you're doing the high stroke, your paddle is going to be way up here, the water is going to run right down the paddle, hit your grip ring, and fall on you. So what I decided I wanted to do is the low stroke, because that keeps the drip ring hopefully off to the side of the boat and away from me. So the first thing I had to learn was how to paddle on the low. And I learned about the paddler's box. You make a box here with the paddle, and now you're going to use your torso as you move and paddle. Now what the experts told me is that they want the paddle stroke to go all the way back to here. Well, as you can see, if I do that, the drip ring is right over my feet and right in the middle of my boat. So I've modified that, and I only go back about this far, and I keep the drip ring away from my legs and away from my boat, and that seems to work pretty well. So if you're bugged by paddle drips and you don't want to try the duct tape solution or spend a lot of money on Neverwet, just change the way you paddle. Just go with a low stroke like this, maintaining your paddler's box and turning your torso to paddle. That's what I think I've learned. If I'm wrong or you've got a better way, please throw it down in the comments below so we can all learn from it. Thanks.